Hello everyone and welcome to the Unreal Engine 4 tutorial series on how to make a crafting system. Last time we left off doing this toggling part when I press 3 I can toggle the crafting UI on and off. Today we're gonna make the crafting UI, complete crafting UI. Before starting, so I want to create an item called money. Last time I didn't create because money is a different factor than others. So it's good to have a separate video for it. So same for the different items like this wood, metal, another. The money would created by creating a child, and I'm gonna call it money. And let's just move it out to my items folder. So this is my money. So yep. In the item structure, what is the name of the item? It is money. Description, I don't think I need a description to provide. It can be added, no it can't be, but it is a pickup beneficial, so whenever I pick up the money my wallet should be increased. Let's say it has the item class of money, and okay, everything is fine. So this is pickup beneficial, so I have to override that pickup benefits function, this one. I don't need this parent blueprint. So what I do when I pick up this, so cast to my player character, because if my money is in the game, in the level, and if I interact with, then I want to pick it up, and I just want to add it. So get my player character. Now from the player character, we previously made a function called add to wallet. Add money to wallet, yeah, right. And after adding the money, I am simply gonna hit success. So what is the amount I want to add? Let's make this amount a variable. So I'm gonna call it a money, and if I pick it up from a game, then I want to add something money. So make it instance editable, because there are different types of money you want to add. Let's say $500, $100. So you can change it instantly. But more importantly, what I need was the money class. So we have done this. Just close it. And now on the big part, the crafting UI. So I want to create a craft slot where I can hover over the slots. So same thing as UI, go to your user interface and click widget blueprint. This would be a craft slot. So open that up. I don't need this canvas panel, I am deleting it. However, what I actually need is a size box. So I am gonna size it, my slot, based on this size box. And let's make it desired so I can view exactly what is gonna look like. So my size box height and width should be 200, 100, because I have made it so I know what are the perfect size for me. You can design it however you want. Then I need a border so that when I hover over, the border is changed. Let's call it a craft border. And let me just add some padding, so it's looks something like this. And then what we need a texture, an image, so that our crafting slots look good. So whatever our image, whatever we want to craft, it goes here. So obviously this padding should be 5, so whenever I hover, this border should change its color. And this is our image, so let's call it a craft image. Hit compile, save. And let's make this border a variable so that we can edit it in the graph. So we have done all the things in the crafting slot designer palette. Let's come in the graph one. So what we need? We need some variables. So first variable is available, or let's say is crafted. First variable is crafted, because if it's crafted, then I don't want to craft it again. So this is a variable, boolean variable of it's crafted. I need another variable called is it available. Available, and this should be instance editable and expose on spawn, so that I can expose it. Then what I need a craft name. So for crafting item name, I'm gonna call it crafting name. This should be a type of a text and instance editable and exposed on spawn. Same thing goes for the description, so I'm just gonna duplicate that description. Okay, what I need now, I need a requirement items and how much amount require for those items to craft it. So this should be a class comma integer pair map. So what I need a map for it, and I'm gonna call it a require items slash amount. So let's say I require a money class of item and I need 30 of it. That's an example. So this should be your master object and class reference, not a object reference. And I need this to be a map. So if you left click on this, you can access all the variables, the single, the array, the set, and the map. I need the map. So you can change it to whatever, but I need an integer right now. Right? And I'm gonna call it an instance editable. So what are the maps? Maps are basically a key value pairs. So this is a key and this is a value. The key can't be same. So you cannot add same key twice because it's unique. You can add this integer however you want, but I'm gonna make it expose on spawn so that I can edit it on the craft UI. We're gonna add more variables in here, but for now I'm happy with this. Yes, we need an enumeration for that. So I'm gonna right click on my content browser, and on the blueprints you're gonna see an enumeration. The enumeration is e_craft_items. So let's make some items. So 1, 2, 3, 4. All the craft items should go here so that we can keep track of all the items. So my first item I want to craft is a pistol holster, then a rifle holster, then again let's craft something called a smoke bomb and a grenade. Okay, you can add however you like. So that variable should go here. So e_craft_item_name. This should be instance editable exposed on spawn, and this is not a variable, this is a single variable, and type would be the enumeration we have just made, craft items, so that we can keep track. Let me show you what we're gonna do now. You can see we have made this craft slots. Let's make this in the crafting UI. So in the crafting UI, if you scroll down a bit, you can see this user created. So you can see this craft slot we have just made. If you drag, you can see it's coming out something like this, but it is just taking up some place because we have just dragged, we haven't specified the layout of it. So I'm just gonna delete it for now. What I need now, I need a vertical box first so that I can keep track of all the things. So a vertical box, and let's provide it in here. Let's set up my anchor point to something in here. Okay, sized content, so whatever the content size is, this vertical box gonna size it accordingly. Position would be 60 60. Yep, in the vertical box I need one horizontal box and again a vertical box. So a horizontal box for all the tabs like a pouch, a rifle holsters, whatever it is, it will go in here. And I again need a vertical box. So that I can keep track of. So yes. Now in this vertical box, make sure this vertical box is child of this vertical box, first one. So in this vertical box, I'm gonna add all the user created craft slots. So if you drag the craft slots and add it to here, it will add it something like this. I'm just duplicate that. So I'm added. So this is my first tab and this is my vertical box which has a border and a text. So let's add a border in the horizontal box and it has some text in it. So yeah, let's set a border to something called a brush color of yellow. If you don't know how to get this saved color, just drag an open in here so you can save it for the next time. So we have done this thing. I think the border is something called not good. So just wrap it up in a size box so that all the size box of this, it will gonna occur with the border. And okay, I done all the thing. What I need now, the size box height and width over it. Width would be 200 because it is our slot size, and height would be how much? 100 too big. 50 is okay. And let's make something padding so it looks much more clean. And we have our border. So I'm gonna just center align the horizontal vertical padding so the text would be in the center. I don't need a padding for the text. So as you can see, I can change the text. So I'm gonna call it a holster. So if you want to add more, you can simply just duplicate that and set it in here. And we have a slot and the holster, something like this. So let's make another one called a pouch, called ammo pouch. For that we need something in here, the enumerations. Ammo pouch upgrade one. And I need another one, ammo pouch upgrade two. And in the crafting UI, let's add this up. So same way, just click on this and duplicate that. So you can see you have added this one. And for the vertical box, if you just duplicate this one, it has added something in here. I think this is not what I wanted. I'm just gonna duplicate the second one and I will wrap this up with a horizontal box. Yep. And now I will duplicate this. So you can see it is adding one and then another and then another. And let's make some padding of 5 so it looks good. Or it is good if I don't provide the padding in here. Rather than that, I provide the padding in the crafting slots. So in the designer palette, in the crafting slots, I can't in here. I have to manually provide it in here. So I will provide padding of 5. Yep, now it is centered perfectly. So if you want another one, you can just duplicate this one. Yes, and for this guy, this one, this would be a pouch. demo pouch 1 2. What I need now, so if you click on this craft slots, you can see we have all the exposed and spawn items which is available to here. So you can just click and edit it whatever you like. So for the first one, this item is available, the rifle one, or sorry, the pistol one. So yes, it is available. Crafting name is a pistol holster. Description will be you can carry one pistol. And require items, let's add items. I need whatever, I need something called a metal of 4, I need a wood of 3, and I need some money. So class would be a money, and let's say how much money, $120. And this craft item should be a pistol also, which is already set it. This one, okay, and we need a item, we need the inventory item photo, the image. So this image, we need a variable called item image text for texture. I'm just gonna expose this on spawn, and this type would be texture 2D. This texture 2D object reference. So you can see now I can access the texture as well. So whatever texture you want to provide, you can provide it here. So let's say for the showing purpose, this is a wood. So it is not showing in here, but if I play, it will show in here. But for the show in here, I need to provide this item text to bind with this one, the image. So this item text variable should be bind with this crafting image. So let's create a binding. So this crafting image should be bound. So I will create a binding. And for this binding, what I need this texture 2D. And I will make a brush from it. Make a brush from the texture. And this would go in here. Hit compile, save, and close this up. So let's play. And let's test it out. If I hit 3, you can see I have bound that item, so it is showing in here. I haven't bound any other texture, so it is not showing in here. So yeah, we have done this. What I need now, in the crafting UI, let's set this guy to available, because the first item in the row should be available so that we can craft accordingly for the second and the third and so on. So this item should be your ammo pouch upgrade one. Right, description would be you can carry up to 3 ammos. You can carry up to 3 throwables. And I need, let's say, a hub, 2 hubs. Let's say, whatever else I need the items which can be added to our inventory, otherwise it won't gonna work. So I need a rare stone of 2. I need some money would be whatever, $40. And this craft item, this should be the ammo pouch upgrade one. Okay, so as you can see, I have done all the thing for these 2 slots. You can do this thing for as many slots as you can. Now for the big part, so let me just make this the crafting details. I want to set the details in here on the right side of whatever the crafting slots you are hovering. So let me just close these things. So for that, what I need a size box in the canvas panel, And let's make this size box anchor to something called in the right side. Zero, position it to zero. And size to content it. So it takes only the size whichever the contents are using. And I need a border inside it. So I have, it's looking this little slow, little small, but we're gonna add it. Then after what I need a vertical box so that I can align all the things vertically. So I need a vertical box, and inside that what I need first is a crafting status that would say what are the status of this crafting. Can I craft it? Can it is available, or is it is already crafted? So this should be a text, and right, let's make this border to something, brush color to something called this guy. Now what I need, first I need to realign. So this alignment of the x axis should be -1, and position would be -600. Oops, not 600, -250. Okay, let's set the height. How many height? 450 would be fine. Yes, I'm happy with 450. So as you can see, I have added a 450 height. And then this is a border. So the position should be not this one. -100 would be fine. Yep. And the Y position would be, should go up something, sorry, minus something, something called here, -120. So it start from this guy and next. So I have a text. What I need now, I need a crafting items name. So I'm Control W, duplicate that. Let's set up this variable name to craft status. Set this variable to craft name. So after the crafting name, what I need a image so that I can show image in here. So let's add an image to this vertical box. Now this image can be greater, so it can be stretched, but I don't need that. I don't want that stretching. So what I'm gonna do, I'm simply gonna wrap it in a size box so that I don't do any stretching. And this size box width would be obviously whatever the width it is using. The height would be 100, no, 200. 200 is fine, I guess. So it won't gonna go beyond 200. And height would be whatever the size box height is. Also, I think it is just starting at the start of this guy, the size box, and I don't want that. So let me provide some padding in this content. Provide from the left side of 10 and the right side of 10. So yeah, now it is fine. So after this image, what I need, let's just name it a craft image. So after this image, I need another text for the description. So I'm just gonna duplicate this guy. This is a craft description. Now, what is the problem with this description is, you can see, if I do something like this guy, it is not wrapping to the next line, it is just flowing back this, and I don't want that. I want this H2 in the second line. So what I will do, if you click on this description and if you go in here, you can see this wrapping. You can do this auto wrapping, but it is not best thing because it takes some time to auto wrap it. So we will do a manual wrap. So let's try with 420. Yep, 420 works exactly fine. From now, after the crafting description, what I need now? I need a vertical box, right? A vertical box. So I'm gonna add the vertical box inside a vertical box, this one. So it is added in here, and this should be a requirement items list. Requirement item list. So whatever the required items should add to as a child in here. So 1, 2, 3, whatever the items you are using. If you using 5 items, then it will use 5 items in here. If you use 1, then it will simply go in 1. I think this description padding should be something called from the top and the bottom. I think it should be 20. Yep. From the requirement also, I think it should be 20 from the bottom. So it won't take much space. And same thing from the status, I think it should be 20 from the top. It is also a part of a UMG creator, so you just create it however you like. It's not matters. I'm gonna add a brush in this guy. So for that we need a border. I wrap it with a border because I need a brush. This brush would be first, let's add padding to 5 and 5 for top and bottom. And the brush color of this would be a yellow. So as you can see, whatever our name would be pop up in the yellow bar. And why the padding is something called here 0. So yep, it is working. Okay, for this I will say to 5. Yep. So okay, everything is fine. Let's check out how it's gonna look when I hit 3. A detail should pop up in here. If you have item, it will pop up in here, and I think it's bit too low. Let me just reposition this size box. This a minus 200. Let's minus how minus 200 looks. Not this one. Yes, minus 200 is fine. Okay, and I think this tag should be a bit low. I'm gonna set the text size to 20, and this padding, the craft border padding, should be on the left of 0. Yes, on the bottom of 5. No, on the top of the 5. Let's see how it's gonna look. So yeah, it is working exactly where I was wanted to. So, and whenever I hover over this, this all the details should pop up, and the status, then the name, then the description, and whatever the items you want. So for that, let's make another widget, and I'm gonna call it an item, single item. And it will gonna add as a child to the requirement items list. So I'm call it a single item. I don't need this canvas pattern. However, what I actually need is a border. And let's make it to a desired. And this border brush color would be alpha of 0 because I don't want to show that border. Or do I actually need a border? I don't think so. I don't need the border. I need a horizontal box actually, because I want to provide items amount space item name. So inside the horizontal box, I need a text, and this text would contain something like this guy 5 wood. So 5 space wood. Let me just set it to 20. But I don't want to set it something like in this. So what I will do, I will simply bind this text. So let me just create a binding. Now for that binding, what I need a variable, and I'm gonna just format that into something so that I can create a binding. So format text, because I want to format it. For that I need two variables. First one is item amount. This should be an integer, and make it exposed on spawn by clicking on instance editable, exposed on spawn. Next thing I need is item name, whatever the item I need to craft something, and this should be also instance editable, exposed on spawn, and this should be type of a text. So grab these two items, get the amount and get the name, and I want to get, and I want to set it in the format text. So let's format it. So if you, whatever you write in the curly brackets, it will take it as an argument. So if I set amount in the curly brackets and if I hit enter, you can see a parameter is added called the amounts, and I can simply drag out a node from here. So I need a curly brackets of amount, then I need a space, and then I need a name, and the curly brackets closed. So you can see whatever in the curly bracket, it is take as an argument. So the name should go here, and this should be bound to the text. Right, so we have done all the things for our inventory, the crafting, the holster and all the things which are in here. I think this is a bit too low. I'm just gonna make it up, this one. A position should be minus 120. Okay, 120 is fine for me. So as you can see, I have done all the things of creating the crafting, and why this is okay, it is done. And what I actually need now is, in the next episode, whenever I hover over this, I want to show the details in here of whatever the item's name, whatever the items are required in here, whatever the description is in. When I hover over again, when I hover, not hovering, it is not visible in here. But I hover, then it is visible. From that, we are gonna do the crafting part, where we actually gonna craft the item, and then after I'm gonna do the crafting benefits of whatever the items we gonna do. So this is all for it now. So thank you so much guys for watching, and bye bye.